The observance will examine how stakeholders such as the government and youth-led and youth-focused organizations are transforming education and how the efforts being made are contributing to the achievement and development of young people. This year's theme highlights efforts to make education more inclusive and accessible for all youth, including efforts by the youth themselves.
I think the theme is very fitting because it's been a while now since we've been hearing people, we've been hearing the education sector globally speaking about transforming education, making it more interactive, making the classroom more interactive, making the curriculums more relevant to the working life of our society. So I think the theme is very fitting. Young persons need to really be able to prepare themselves for the workplace, for the job market. And we are seeing with the high rates of unemployment and the lack of support for entrepreneurship, basically, young persons need to see how they can educate themselves to battle or to be competitive in the job market.
He says preparing the youth for challenges of the future requires a lot more than formal education. It requires direct interaction between young people and the institutions trying to solve these problems.
We need to discover the correct formula for making TVET education more accessible or more accepted in our schools or for students. We need to see the concept of internship being revisited, where the business sector is more confident in supporting the Ministry of Education in advancing internship opportunities. We want young persons to be exposed to the real world of work even whilst they are in school. The issue of responsibility and financial management, a lot of us, we leave school and we don't understand how to manage finance, how to really build wealth for ourselves. And so I think in terms of internship and practicing what we learn, that has to be incorporated more in the education system.
International Youth Day was first observed on August 12, 1999. For the DBS News World, I am Sheffield Gillard.